Hi everyone, my name is Vered and today we're going to do a Pilates mat exercise and I'm going to use a flex band for some of the exercise. We'll start lying on our back. Let's take the hands and place them on the rib cage on the side and start from breathing. Inhale through the nose and exhale, blow all the air out. And again, deep inhale, fill your lung, and then exhale, blow all the air out and try to engage your deep core muscles to start working. And again, inhale, and exhale. I'm going to take my flex band in my arms, like this, and I'm going to bring the arms overhead, inhale. And exhale, down towards the legs. Again, inhale, and I have a little bit tension in my band. And exhale, forward. And I want you to look at your rib cage, make sure they're not pumping up when the arms come overhead, and then stretch them back. Let's do two more. Breathe, inhale, lift it up. And exhale, lower them down. So if you will watch my hand, they're not going all the way down to the floor. Just to the place that I can keep my rib cage connected and then lower it down. Bring the arms up to the ceiling, the same line with your shoulders, and just open the band and release. So I'm opening my arm to the side and controlling the way in. And breathe, inhale. And exhale, slowly resist the band. Let's do three more here. Breathe, inhale. And exhale. Good, and two. Slowly release, and one. I'm going to bring the arm again overhead, and I'm going to do a chest lift. Start with the arms to the legs, now the chin, lift the chest, reach down forward, and I'm trying to keep my spine in a neutral position, means I have a little bit space here under my lower back. Bring it back down all the way. Inhale, and exhale, now the chin, lift it up. And slowly control the way down. Up, nodding the chin and lift. And down. One more inhale. And exhale. Let's stay up here again, keeping your spine neutral and just open down to the side and release. And if it's too much for your neck, just take the head down and open for four more. And breathe three. And two, and one, back to the center, and release. I'm going to place this band under my scapula. So behind my scapula, around this area, or the bra line. And I'm going to round down again to my spine. My hands are reaching up to the ceiling, and make sure you have a little bit of tension in the band. I'm going to do the protraction and retraction movement. So I'm reaching down to the ceiling and then I'm pressing my shoulder down to the mat. Again, lift it up and exhale down and up and pressing the scapula and the shoulder down. Let's do three more. Reaching down, up and press and lift for two and down. Last one, and down. Let's do a scissor movement. One arm next to the leg and one next to the ears. And switch, and breathe. Keep working. Keep the same distance between the rib cage to the hips, so nothing is popping up. And four more, and three, and two. And one, up to the ceiling, release. And I'm going to take this band out. And I'm going to put it under my knees in the center, flip it over like this, that I have the two edges here on this side. And we're going to do the 100. So start with keeping your legs in a tabletop position, imprint your spine, not the chin, lift the chest up, and I'm starting to pump. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'm I'm not just pumping for my arms. I'm really trying to push down every time and keep resistance in the bend. And keep breathing. In, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Maybe try to lift your chest 1 inch more up and keep pumping and keep breathing. And let's do 20 more here. Breathe in, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Last 10. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. And hold. Slowly bend the knee in. Give yourself a little bit of a hug here. And breathe. Let's place the hands on your knee and rock yourself up to a sitting position. I'm going to keep the bend where it is, and I'm going to keep the legs together. Hands are out to the side. And we're going to do the half fold down here. Breathe, inhale, grow tall from your spine first, and then articulate the spine slowly in control that my sacrum is touching here. And then slowly articulate the spine back up. Again, squeeze your glutes in, rounding the spine halfway. And I have a C-curve position in my spine. And then slowly lift it back up. Again, inhale. Exhale, keep tension in the bend, rounding down. And let's stay down here. Now I'm going to press the bend down to the mat and release. So diagonal down and back. And breathe, and I'm trying to stay low. My abs are connected and working, and I'm pressing from the back of my shoulders. Four more. And three. Exhale, two. And one. Release and stretch. Let's place the band here on my toes. And for the next one, I'm going to try to keep my legs straight here. Start from sitting up nice and tall, rounding the spine down to the same position where we've been in half roll down. And I'm going to take my palms, face them up to the ceiling, and I'm going to do biceps here. So I'm going to bend in, control the release. Bend in, control the release, and breathe. Inhale and exhale, bend in. Let's do six more. Bend in, five, and release. Exhale, four, and three, and two, and down, and release. Flexion forward and rest. The next exercise will be the roll up with a band. Hands are starting here. And then I'm going to roll halfway down and slowly articulate the spine, one vertebra at a time, that my head will be the last one. Breathe, inhale, exhale, nod the chin, reaching down forward, use the band to help you come up and flexion forward. Try to keep the spine rounded and melt down, bone by bone, down to the floor. And breathe, inhale. Exhale, nod the chin and try not to use the bend so much if you want to make it harder. Articulate the spine. Slowly in control. Down to the mat. Exhale, lift. Try to keep the abs in. And let's do it just one more time. Rounding down. Slowly. Breathe, inhale. Exhale, nodding the chin and lift. Stay here for a second. Flex the toes towards your body and breathe. Slowly articulate the spine up. And I'm going to bend my knees and taking the strap out. Again, place it behind my scapula, the bra line. I want you to find a position that works for you, that you can sit up nice and tall with neutral spine. For me, this one works. You can also take your legs straight if you cannot bend from your hips. And I'm going to extend the bend out to the side. And I'm going to do the twist movement that the band is under my scapula where the bra line is. Breathe, inhale, and exhale, three pulses. One, and two, and three, back to the center. Inhale, and exhale, pulse. One, and two, and three, and center. And if you watch my hands, they're not moving here. I'm keeping the same distance with the flex band. And I'm just going to take twist here. One, and two, and three, and center. Both of my sit bones are down to the mat, especially the opposite side. One more each side. Exhale. One, two, three, and center. Shoulders stay down. Two, three, center, and release. I'm going to take the band and I'm going to tie it up like you're doing your shoes around your knees. Before you do it, just make sure that you have a little bit tension here, and then tie it up in a way that you can release it after. Okay, and I'm going to place it a little bit above my knees. Articulate the spine down, bone by bone, hands by the side of the body. Start from neutral spine, tilting the pelvis towards the body, roll up the spine, bone by bone, all the way up to your shoulders. My legs are hip distance apart, my feet are flat down on the floor, hands down, hips are even. Inhale, slowly melt down, one vertebra at a time, all the way down, back to neutral position. Again, my knees are a little bit resisting out, so I'm keeping hip distance apart here. Lift it up and hold. Exhale, slowly articulate the spine down, all the way to neutral. On your next one, we're going to stay up. Articulate it up, lift it. And I'm going to stay up and even with my hips, and I'm going to press my knees out and then control the way in and out. So we work on the outside of the legs here. And breathe and press out. Try to keep your hips even here. And breathe. Exhale to press. Inhale to release. Exhale. Five more of these. And four. Keep the rib cage down and in. And three. And exhale. Two. Last one, and then slowly articulate the spine, slowly in control. Let's do one more version of this one. Breathe, inhale, exhale, tilt the pelvis, rounding it up all the way to your shoulders, and I'll try to release one leg up and then down, and I'm keeping my legs hip distance apart with a little bit resist in the bend. And I'm just trying to lift the leg up, point the toes, and then lower it down. Try to place your hands on your hip bones. Make sure that they stay even. Nothing is dropping. So when I lift my right leg, my left glutes and hamstring are working hard, and then lower it down. And lift. Let's do four more. And breathe, exhale, four, and down. And up, three, and down, and exhale, two, and down, last one, and down, slowly melt down, bone by bone, all the way down, bend your knee to your chest, and breathe. I'm going to do the double leg stretch, the slow double leg stretch. So I'm starting with my leg in a diamond shape position. So my feet are touching, my knees are more than hip distance apart. Upper body is down on the floor. Start from the 100 position. So I'm extending my legs, reaching my arms, and then I'm breathing the arm overhead, circle them in, back to the diamond shape, release the head. Again, float first, 100 position, reaching the arm opposite, circle them in, lift the chest, and go down to the diamond shape. Again, lift, up, reach, circle the arm, lift, and diamond, and release. Let's do two more. Up. And bend down, last one. Lift and stretch. Stretch up, circle them. And then bend in and release the chest down to the floor. And breathe. Let's open the T, the arm to T position. Place the leg to the tabletop position again. Imprint the spine. So I'm pushing my lower back down to the floor. And I'm just going to open the knee out to the side and bring them back in. And again, push out. Keep the feet together. Just the knees pushing out. Three more here. And breathe. Two. Last one. Let's keep the legs a little bit apart, or just the knees a little bit apart. And I'm going to shift my weight to one side and then bring it back to the center. So both of the shoulders stay down on the mat. And I'm keeping the same resistance with my band here between my knees. Shift your weight. Obliques working hard to bring you back to the center. One more. Let's do it again, but this time we're going to stay to the side and we're going just to close the knees and open them. Breathe, inhale and exhale. Two more on this side. Again, both of the shoulders stay down on the mat, center. Tilt and hold, squeeze the opposite shoulder down. And we're going to do five here and open for four. It's hard exercise. Three, and exhale. Two, and one. Back to the center. Bend your knees, and release. Round yourself up, nodding the chin. And we're going to do the seal here with the same position with the bend. So I'm going to open my leg out, bringing my hands in, like this. You're going to round back up, sitting up nice and tall, all the way up, finding the balance. Say again, round to your shoulders, round back up and hold, breathe, inhale, try to use your abs to come back up and finding the balance. Three more, and lift it up, try to really round your lower back to keep the movement smooth. Last one, round, round back up, hold. Let's try to release the arms here to a V position. And now try to open the knees and close them up in this position. And breathe. Five more. In four. Breathe three. Exhale two. Last one, hands on your knees. Lower the leg down and flexion forward. And breathe. Try to dip. Breathe deep into the back of your rib cage. And then exhale, blow all the air out. Articulate the spine back up. And let's do a little bit of a side work. So I'm going to start with bringing this band here. Just a little bit above your ankle. And you're going to be down on the side of the body, the side of the mat. We start from finding the same long line here, and then I'm going to bring my legs a little bit forward to diagonal just to be more stable here. Upper hands can be here in front of the chest, but make sure that you're still working here on your side and you're not just resting with the upper body. We start from bringing the upper leg up, and then slowly control all the way down. Breathe and lift and lower. Exhale. So try to lift it up and then resist the way down. And breathe and lift. Exhale, five more. Keep the upper shoulder down. And four. And breathe, three. Lift it up, two. On the last one, we're going to stay up. And do small pulses up. Pulse up and up and up, like 1 or 2 inches. Lift, lift. It's 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower it down. Let's try to bring both of the legs up. Both of them up and both of them down. And breathe and lift. So for this one, I'm not using the band. But just keep it there for the next one. And lift. Exhale, five more. Both of the legs working as one unit. Four. I'm working here on the side. Three. Exhale, two. Last one, let's hold it up and do small scissor movement when the legs are up here. One to the front, one to the back. And switch. And switch. So I'm pushing out and bring them in. Push out and bring them in. Five more. Exhale, four. And three. Two. Last one, together, lower them down. Roll to your back and I'm going to change. And bring this again above my knees. Roll back to the side and let's change. And be on the elbow. So my elbow is under my shoulder and I'm not resting here. I'm trying to keep my abs working. My rib cage are lifted. Hands can stay here in front of the chest. My feet are together. And I'm going to open the knee out and then slowly release. Open. The upper knee up to the ceiling and then release. And breathe and open. And exhale, open. Three more. And open. And release. And two. On the last one, we'll stay open and do small pulses. Pulse out and out. And breathe. Try to keep the resistance on the bed all the time. Open. Five. Four. Open. Three. It's hard. Two, one, and release it down, and breathe. Try to lift yourself up, and I'm going to take an opposite stretch here. So I'm trying to look up to the ceiling, feel the stretch all the way out here on the side of the body, and then try to twist, hold the shin, and give yourself a little bit of a twist here, of a stretch. And slowly come up and do the other side. So we start with this band just above the ankle. I'm just going to stretch my mat here before we do it. On the side, you can support the head, you can put it down here or stretch, I don't care. It should feel comfortable for you. I'm lifting up from my waist, my legs are a little bit out to the diagonal, upper hand support. Only the upper leg is going to come up and then down. Lift and lower and breathe. Exhale, push up. Inhale, release and lift. Let's do four more of this and then the small pulses. This is three. Make sure that the hips are even. I'm not shifting my weight here. Forward or backward, two. One. The next one we're going to stay up and do small pulses. Up, up, up and breathe. The outside of the leg is working here. Five more. Four, three, two, one and hold and release. Work the legs as one unit. Lift them up, lower them down. Exhale, lift. And breathe and up. And lift. Four more. And up for three. Again, hips are even, two. Last one, I'm going to lift the leg up and stay and do the scissor movement. One to the front, one to the leg, and then forward. And it's not just kicking them. I'm going to open and stay here for a second and center. Open and stay here for a second and center. Four more and breathe. Exhale, three and center. Last two. And one. Together and release. Roll to your back. Change the position of the band above your knees. Go down to the side. Up to the elbow. Again, make sure you're lifting here. Legs are together. And I'm going just to open the knee out. And release. And breathe and open. And exhale, open five more. And four. Keep breathing. Three. Push out. Two. One. And now we're going to do the small pulse, so keep it open. And just push, push. Think about bringing the knee up to the ceiling. Up. Open here. And breathe. Four. Four more. And three. And two. One. And hold. Bring the knees in. Push yourself up. Give yourself a contour stretch. Try to open the chest up to the ceiling. Bend the right elbow and stretch. And then twist. And I'm going to really push and twist my chest here down. And release. Let's undo and tight this bend. And we're doing a little bit of a lower back work here. So I'm going to place this bend behind my back. And then I'm going to go down. My legs are the same wide as the mat. Pointed toes, bring the heels down. Hands are holding the bend right now. So make sure they're the same line with the shoulder. And you can have a little bit resistance here to work. Start with the head down. Shoulders are down to the mat. The first movement is just nod the chin, lift it up, and push the shoulders back. And then push the shoulders back down, release the head. Again, head first, and from protraction, you're going to retraction of the shoulders, and then release. Arms stay down for this one. Again, just the shoulders lift, and lower them down. One more of these. Up and down. On the next one, it starts the same, but the arms are floating up and I'm trying to lift the chest, maybe 1 inch more. And then release it down. And again, now the chin lift. And then lower it down. Inhale. And exhale, shoulders, chest. Hands. Two more of this. Breathe. Inhale. Head, shoulder, chest. Last one will stay up. Lift it up. Hold. And I'm just going to open the bend and release. And breathe and open. Exhale. And up. And out. Five. Four. Three. Two. One. And release. And breathe. Let's bring the bend over the head and forward. And we're going to do the swimming here. My hands are forward, and instead of pumping the arms like this, I'm going to open the arm like this. Every time my legs are doing the swimming movement. So start with the legs straight. Lift everything up, hands and legs. Arms are going up and open and hold, and the legs are doing the swimming movement. So keep your glutes in, keep your legs straight, point the toes. Think about kicking with your legs quickly, and the hands are just staying here, holding the resistance of the bend. And breathe for 10 more, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, hold. And lower it down and breathe. Let's take a child pose here, just to give yourself a contour stretch to your lower back. And breathe. Rounding the spine up. And I'm going to be on the same position, down on my belly. Let's put the bend on the side for a second. My hands are doing this position like a diamond, and my head is resting on them. My legs are bent, my heels are touching here. And the first exercise is just squeezing the heels together. So I don't think you can see anything in the picture, in the video, but just think about squeezing your knees, your heels together, And you start to activate all the muscles in the back of the leg, the glutes working. Let's do three more squeezes. And exhale, squeeze two. And exhale, squeeze one. Now let's try to keep the same position with the legs. I'm just going to lift the knee up and then lower them down. Again, lift the knee, keep the same position with your legs and lower them down. My glutes is working on this exercise, lift. Now I'm trying to lift and also squeeze your heels together and release. Up, lift and squeeze and lower down. Up and lift and squeeze and lower down. Three more, up and squeeze and down. Up and squeeze, two and release. Last one, up and squeeze and hold five, squeeze in four, three, two, one, and release. Extend your legs, take the bend and again bring it behind your back. We're going to do the double leg stretch with the bend behind my body. So, started with the hands the same line with your shoulders to the back. Head is facing one side, keeping the shoulders down to the mat. You're going to kick the heels twice towards the body, lift the chest to extension, and then move to the other side. Let's do it. Kick two times. Flex the toes. One, two. Point the toes, stretch, lift the chest up, and I'm trying to open the band here a little bit. Change the head to the other side, lower it down. Again, kick in. One, two. Point and lift. Switch side and down. Kick. One, two, point and lift. Switch. And again, I'm trying to open the bend here. And release. Kick. One, two, point and lift. Switch side. Let's do it three more times. Kick. Point and lift. And down and kick. One, two, lift it up. Just last one, let's do it here. Bend, bend. Let's stay here on this position and just open the arm and release. Open to the back, five. Open, four. Breathe, three. Exhale, two. One. Lower it down and release. Push yourself up to a child pose. Stretch your lower back. Rounding the spine up, and I'm going to go down to my back. Again, I'm going to place this band here around my toes. So you can see how it's wrapped from the middle all the way to the big toe here. In the middle of the band, hands by the side of the body, rounding the spine up. Two option for the leg without the band. It can be bent here or extended all the way up, all the way down to the floor. Start from reaching the leg with a band, it's my right leg, up to the ceiling. And it can be to the diagonal if this doesn't work for you. Try to point the toes here and then flex. Feel the stretch all the way to the back of your leg. And breathe, inhale and exhale. Point and flex. Now just do a circle movement here with the toes. One side, and then circle to the other side. And breathe. Finding the center, pointing the toes, and we'll do the leg circle here. So you can do it with the leg straight, or with the knee bent, and if the knee bends, so think that the knee is what moving or what doing the circle up to the ceiling. So or with the knee bent, or with the leg straight, open the leg out to the side, and try to control the bend here. And it's not just working on the leg here, it's also work on your pelvis, on your hips here. So try to keep the pelvis down and neutral without shifting your weight from side to side, and cross and switch the direction. And what helps us stable this, the pelvis will be the abs. So abs are in, help us stable. One more this direction. Let's bring the leg up to the ceiling, open the arms up. And I'm just going to push and feel the stretch to the back of my leg. It's a nice stretch, it should feel good. Just try to make sure that the shoulders stay down. And then send it back to the diagonal, and we're going to switch the legs. So I'm going to place the other leg on the same position. Again, opposite leg can be bent or extend, whatever works for you. And we just start from extending the leg and bend. And breathe and stretch. And bend, keeping the leg straight. Point the toes and then flex. And breathe, point and flex. Two more. Make sure there is no tension in the upper body. And then just do circle with the toes. And then circle to the other direction. Find the center, leg circle, point the toes. Again, the knee can be straight or bent, whatever works for you. And try to keep the pelvis stable. And breathe, inhale, and exhale. Inhale, and exhale, switch the direction. Cross the leg, down and circle it up. Breathe. Three more. And exhale, two. And one, up to the ceiling. Hands are going to extend up. Keep the shoulders down and just feel the stretch in the back of the leg. And breathe. Place the bend on the side, hands under your knees, and slowly lift yourself up to a sitting position. Hands to the side, let's place the right leg on your left knee, and just try to push this knee down, open the chest up, and stretch, and breathe. And switch legs. Open, try to look up, try to push the knee down towards the mat. Feel the stretch here. And breathe. And release. Let's again take this bend and do it above your knees. Easy to take it in and out. And I'm going to be in a hands and knees tabletop position here. Again, the bend is just above my knees. Shoulders above my hands, hips above my knees, and I'm starting from neutral spine here. Cat stretch, tuck the toes under, rounding the spine. Look down at your belly, keep the shoulders away from your ears, and then articulate the spine tail to head all the way to extension. Again, tuck the pelvis under, think about an angry cat here, and then down and open. Two more, round in, open and stretch, extension, last one, round, round back up, open. Finding the center here, try to tuck the toes under, try to keep your spine neutral and just lift the knee up and down, and breathe and lift and lower. Five more, up four, again spine stay neutral, abs stay in, three, lift two, and the last one will stay up, and we're just going to push the knee out and release, out, out, five and four, three, two, one. Bring the knee down and sit. I'm going to change to an opposite. So think about an opposite. So now the feet will be hip distance apart, hands behind the body, and I'm going to lift the pelvis up. And again, your knees should be above your legs, and lower the pelvis down. And exhale, lift try not to sink with the chest here. So think about pushing the shoulders down, open the chest up, and I'm not looking up to the ceiling, I'm just trying to look out to the yellow here. Lower the pelvis down. Breathe and lift up, squeeze your glutes, and down. Up. My knees are still pushing out to keep the hip distance apart. So I have a little bit of resistance here in the bend. Three more. And down. Exhale, two. Last one, we'll stay up here. And I just want you again to open the legs out and release. Out. Try to keep the hips up and even. And open five more. And four. Breathe, three. Exhale, two. Last one. Lower it down. Stretch the leg forward. And give yourself a little bit of a stretch here. And breathe. Rounding the spine up. Let's bring this bend again, just in the middle of my shin here. And we're going to do the plank exercise. So starting with the hands stable, and you can do it here or down your elbow, whatever works for you. And you're going to extend the legs out, lower the pelvis down. Make sure you have the same line between your heels to your head. And just hold this plank position first. And breathe for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The next one, we're going to open the leg to the side and then bring it back in. Open one leg to the side, bring it back in. Open the other leg to the side and in. And breathe, right leg. And center. Try not to sink with your pelvis. So try to keep the same position with your upper body. And let's do five more. And then four. Down. Three. Exhale, two. And one. Release. Bend the knee in and stretch to a child pose. And breathe. The next one will be the push-up. So you can do it in a full plank position, or you can do it just above your knees. Here. And I'm going to go down on three, up on three. Down, two, three. Up, two, three. Down, two, three. I'm bending my elbow back and diagonal. Down, two, three. Lift, two, three. Good, down. Exhale, up, down, up. Let's do two more. Down, two, three, up, two, three. Last one, and up. Uncross your legs, walk back, and let's take this one out. I'm going to place it in the middle here. And I'm going to sit with my leg crossed here. So I'm sitting on the bend. I'm going to take my right arm here and bring the elbow up to the ceiling. I'm trying to sit up nice and tall, keeping both of the shoulders down. And I'm just going to extend right arm out to the diagonal, bend back in. And extend. So it's triceps work here. And breathe. Bending and extending the arm, keeping both of the shoulders down. And it's up to you how much resistance you want. With a bend here, you can do it light or you can do it hard. Three more. Out. And breathe. Two. And one. Let's do the other side. Release. Again, so I'm starting here. Elbow out, sitting up nice and tall, extending the arm and bend, and breathe. Exhale out, let's do six, and bend, five, and breathe out, three more. And two. Last one. And release. You can take the bend out here. Let's open the legs out to the side. I'm placing one arm in front, one in the back. And I'm trying to push and open a little bit more. Hands are forward. And you're going slowly to walk forward. Release your upper body. And try to breathe. Inhale. And on your exhale, try to sink down one more inch. Again, inhale. Exhale, sink down one more inch. Breathe, inhale. And exhale, stretch forward. Again, in. And sink down. Let's do it one more time. And down, and let's just stay down here and stretch and breathe. Slowly walk your hands to one side, and I'm going to try to bring my chest towards the knee and stretch and breathe. From the center, let's move to the other side. Again, chest towards the knee and breathe. Walk back to the center, rounding the spine up. Bring the legs together, and I'm going just to place one leg. So my right leg is the same line with my left knee. And I'm going to reach the toes, and I will do it to the diagonal. And just flex forward and breathe. Articulate the spine up. The same knee, the right knee, you're going to bring it down to the mat. And then I want you to walk down. You can stay here. You can go down to the elbow. You can stay all the way down. It's up to you. I just want you to feel the stretch here in the front. Try to really bring the knee down. Try to do the imprint position, tucking the pelvis under to feel the stretch. And just stay here and breathe. Slowly come up from this position and switch side. So right leg is straight, left knee is bent, the same line here with my right knee, and I'm going to reach my arms down to my toes and try to flex forward and feel the stretch. Rounding the spine up, taking the same left knee, bring it in. Go down, whatever spot that works for you, and just do the imprint position, tuck the pelvis under, feel the stretch here, and breathe. Slowly, let's come up of this position, cross your legs, stretch the arms a little bit. So first we're going to bring the right arm forward, and I'm going to press with my left arm. I want you to try to think about keeping both of the shoulders down, and I'm not resting with my upper body. I'm trying still to sit up nice and tall on my sit bone. And let's do the other side. Stretch. And breathe. Let's bring the elbow up. So elbow up to the ceiling. Try to open the chest, look up, and feel the stretch. And switch, open. And release, hand on your knees. Sink down and breathe. And then press your arms on your knees. Look up, open the chest again, rounding down. Open and stretch. Finding the center, let's breathe up. Exhale, blow all the air out.